MSG is MSG is a flavor enhancer. And that's all I know about it.
Umami 话味精系对身体唔好嘅，所以大家唔好食咁多味精。味精可能是鸡精，吃起来有点廉价的味道，感觉那个味道有点假。
MSG is a flavor enhancer that no one can seem to decide if it's bad for you or not. This is Eat China, where we uncover the stories of the food we eat. In this season, we're going back to basics, to the building blocks of Chinese flavor. Let's talk about MSG. It looks like a white powder. It was invented by Japanese scientist Kikunae Ikeda in 1908. He was trying to recreate the taste of kelp broth. He called that taste umami. It means the essence of deliciousness. This is Marshall Liu. He studies chemical and biomolecular engineering.
So umami is one of the five basic tastes, including the bitter, sour, sweet, and salty. It is a persistent and a lingering taste, which will give you mouth-watering sensation. Glutamic acid from kombu seaweed is responsible for the umami taste.
Glutamic acid is an amino acid. It exists in lots of food that contains protein, like cheese and meat, and even mushrooms and tomatoes. When we bite into the food, this amino acid is released and dissolves on the part of the tongue that picks up umami.
We sense the taste and pass the signal to the brain. It tells us this is something good because it means protein. It is the basic and fundamental nutrients to our health. Then our brain will tell, yeah, this is good, keep eating them. So it's also called a meatness.
It's the reason why mushrooms are also often used to substitute meat in vegetarian dishes.
All people like umami.
如果没有了鲜味，食物不能称之为美味。
This is Qi Mingchun. He makes food created by Peng Zu, one of China's earliest famous chefs. Peng Zu's cooking was all about umami in creating nourishment. One of his specialties was chicken soup. The Chinese word for umami is xian. Its character is written as a combination of fish and lamb.
Yangfengcangyu shi Xuzhou mingcai, ye shi Peng Zu cai daibiaocai zhi yi.
Lamb is steamed with an entire fish to amp up the umami. Chef Qi also uses aromatics to enhance the dish's flavor.
蒜是可以去掉一部分异味的，它的膻味和鱼的腥味，姜也是一样，然后再附上这个白芷这种中药材。制道菜只用盐，一定要控制住所有的调味料的一个量。
Glutamic acid is released slowly as the food cooks.
我们来给它蒸制，大约呢就是20分钟以上。但是最佳状态是蒸制1小时以上。That's
too long for most restaurants. So many of them use a shortcut, adding a pinch of MSG.
MSG is a sodium salt of the glutamic acid. MSG itself has no strong flavor. It enhances the flavor. It will create a stronger umami taste. Our body cannot tell the difference between the natural glutamic acid or the MSG. Basically, they are the same thing.
So does MSG really make our food more delicious? We did a taste test. We prepared two types of scrambled eggs, one with MSG and one without.
You are too tall. Down, down. Okay.
Right. So for me, the best one is this one, and it's more flavorful and it's less eggy. Yeah, it's really more umami.
This machine used to make MSG is called a fermenter. Here's a mini version of the much bigger ones they have in factories.
MSG is produced through the fermentation process. So basically, bacteria convert starch or the sugar solution to the MSG. In this fermenter, you see this is the sugar solution. And we put the bacteria in. After the purification, add crystallization, we get the solid MSG.
Loads of things we eat contain MSG. Instant noodles, chips, and ketchup.
Some people say they are thirsty after eating food with MSG, but the real reason may be attributed to high table salt inside. Sodium ions are responsible for salty taste. MSG contains around one-third sodium compared with salt.
Sometimes it's labeled as E621 instead because people feel irked. That's because MSG's bad rap started way back in the 1960s.
Asian chefs always get asked if their food has MSG, even though a chef of a different culture, like a Western chef, would never get asked that question.
Every time you go to a Chinese restaurant, you'll find a customer there saying, "No MSG."
This is Michelle Jalen. She's a dietitian that debunks myths about MSG.
The FDA said MSG is safe. This was back in 1958.
Remember Ikeda? After his discovery, he co-founded a company called Ajinomoto. It's still one of the world's top MSG producers. In the 1930s, they started selling MSG as a flavor enhancer to food manufacturers in the US.
North America, Campbell Soup Company, it's a canned soup, started becoming a thing, and they realized it can take MSG and it can make canned soup taste a lot better. It was used in canned soups. Housewives at the time were all buying it, using it in their cooking. And then something begins to shift, and there was that famous letter that was written by Robert Homan Kwok to the New England Journal of Medicine, saying that Chinese food causes all these problems, headaches, heart palpitations, migraines, nausea, all these symptoms, but it was all based on anecdote. It wasn't based on science, and it got published as science.
The title of Dr. Ho's letter was Chinese Restaurant Syndrome. He suggested MSG in Chinese food was one of the reasons he fell sick, and he urged researchers to look into it.
The first few studies done on MSG were really poor studies. What they did was they took MSG and they would inject it into mice. And so what happened was the mouse got sick, right? But at the same time, we don't have the same DNA, and a mouse is tiny and humans are not that tiny. So that's where they got the idea that MSG was bad.
The American media picked up on the letter and published stories demonizing MSG and Asian food. The damage was done. Even today, tons of people avoid MSG because they think it's bad for them.
It's about time now we start debunking it, and people like myself, who is a registered dietitian, to like not be afraid to come forward and talk about it. There's a lot of stigma against Asian food as not being healthy or being like bad for you. And that's not a very culturally inclusive way of talking about food, saying that a whole culture's food is bad. Myths are very hard to bust, and I do get people pushing back. And a positive note is that more people want to know, more people are curious, more people want to talk about it. And that, to me, is the great benefit to promoting it and to debunking the myths.
Up next, we're going to show you the three infinity stones you always find in a Chinese kitchen. Stay tuned.